Let me see if I get it. You just wake up at 7 o'clock in the morning and you go in the morning. Then you go to the university and after the university you wait for the swimming pool.
What the heck? Why? Why are you doing that? Like, why? Is it like a body thing or is it because of a mind thing? Or is it both? I mean, do you really like, I mean, do it like for the body, for the mind? I also like practice now. I can understand it. I mean, I'm doing this bigger. It's a hot yoga. And it's like a swimming pool, but without the water. I mean, we ended up like all wet. I mean, I understand it, like the concept of, you know, achieving this with the body and mind and how they go together. And I kind of feel it. I feel in the sense that, you know, I stretch my body and then I stretch my mind. My mind goes with it. And yeah, it's like this sensation of feeling prepared, you know. It's, I mean, like jogging and swimming pool, it's just too much. Concept of unexpected things, and I like it. And I think we never get prepared by the unexpected. No matter, like, no matter how much physical practice you really develop, and it's just like unexpected things are just so artificial. Like, do we really get ready? You know, how much do we move? Thinking about like relationships at the same time, like, you know, how much do we connect with ourselves? I've been thinking a lot today about how can we become like these ecological lovers all the time, like, you know, constantly recycling our own emotions together, like sustaining ourselves. Now, just calm down. For me right now, you know, I'm so in this situation. Lately, I've been looking to the sky. It's something that I don't do. It's very unexpected for me. You know, like understanding that there is a sky, and it's so beautiful. Like, you know, understanding that I cannot be here just existing. It's just something that, you know, I believe that we should live and not just exist. You know, and I think it's so important, but how do you do it, you know? How do you actually... How do we know that we are really living, you know? Likewise, speaking of living, how is your relationship? Is it have the same boyfriend? Or is it the next boyfriend? You know, you can really have to start talking about how do you live yourself in your relationships? Because relationships are there because of you. It's not really because of the other. It's like you engage with the other because of yourself. And you just have to understand how much are you expanding. I mean, if you are engaged in a relationship and you don't expand, it's just like, are you really learning something? Just, you know, just like being in a relationship because, oh, I'm in a relationship. Oh, that's cute. That's so nice, you know. And how much do you give yourself? How much do you receive? I mean, do you want to receive anything? And then speaking of like new processes and new learning, how is your bachelor program? I mean, I wonder how much do you learn there? Are you still learning? Are you still there?
I think it's interesting,
in terms of learning, to understand where is your limits, and to understand within the limits, how much you can either grow, or either, just stick to the things that you believe, basically. But there's something like... Where is your own limitations? How much you can carry on? Like for example, like this. How much are you going to carry this situation? You have to understand that you have limits. And you have to understand that as much as you would like to keep on carrying,
you cannot carry for that long.
I mean, at least not alone. I mean, you're never asking me for help, girl.
I'm not good.
But listen. This is all about this recycling relationship that I believe that we have to keep on doing, you know? And I also believe that at some point you should leave this space, because there are things that are not really recyclable, like, you know, a pain on the knee or a pain in whatever you might feel. And you never think about it, but exactly how pain is, how what? Thank you.